Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and welcome to the MGM Grand here on the Vegas Strip in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, for tonight's main event. Eight rounds in the heavyweight division between Mike Tyson and Evander Holyfield. Mike Tyson's focus is front and center as he makes his way to the ring right now. Evander Holyfield so alert right now. I mean, look at his focus as he makes that walk that so many fighters dread, but he makes that walk down to the ring just so very alert.
In the middle corner, by way of Brooklyn, across the ring, his professional record consists of 43 wins, with 28 knockouts and 10 defeats. Fighting out of Atlanta, Evander the Real Deal Holyfield.
All right, fellas, let's have a good, clean fight. Touch him up and let's go.
Anticipated scheduled eight round bout.
In a matchup like this, Teddy, with a power puncher against a fast fighter, who has the advantage the longer the fight goes on?
Well, almost always it's going to be the power guy because he's not going at a fast rate. He's saving himself, he's placing his punches. The quick guy, he's letting it all go.
He got hit, but he sends it right back. Hurt by a superb hook to the head.
Get your hands up!
That is a classic Tyson uppercut. Good shot to the head with that right hand. Not hitting his mark there going upstairs. Halfway through round number one. Evander Holyfield scoring with that right hand. And you see what he can do when he sends that right to the head. Evander Holyfield's crushed by a huge uppercut.
Come on, get focused.
Well-placed hook. Staying away from those headshots with his defense up top. Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Last 10 seconds. A little something for his opponent after getting tagged. And that's the end of round one. Tyson's commitment to the cause of being the aggressor really had him in front in that last round. Look at his opponent.
You're in complete control.
Here we go. Round two is underway. He missed with that headshot. Blocks the headshot. Tyson's right hand working well that time. He scored well. Able to show you his blocking ability.
Use
And he's holding.
Must be the punch of the day. Both guys bringing home uppercuts. 90 seconds to go here in this round. Through the years, especially in the heavyweight division, there have been some guys that can throw a good right uppercut. But when Tyson fully dips and gets all that body behind it, it's as good a right uppercut as we've ever seen.
Yeah, it's coming from Brooklyn. You know, it's coming from a place that really you wish that you didn't have to visit because you get hit with that punch. He's putting everything into it, but he sets it up nice. He hits you behind the back a little bit in the rib area, and then all of a sudden, when your arm moves a little bit, it's coming up the middle.
Scored well upstairs with the right hand. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Well timed by Mike Tyson. He took a step back, landed the counter punch.
Exactly what he wanted to do.
And that's the end of round two. Evander Holyfield's going to need to do a good job of protecting himself because he started swelling in the midst of that last round.
Let's see some defense and more punches.
Good action here tonight. Both guys bringing their best, and both guys meeting each other stride for stride, punch for punch. Tough fight to score here as we're back underway. Up top with the right hand. Teddy, what would you recommend based on what we're seeing here tonight?
Well, two aspirin and then go. Oh, no. Actually, I would say a little counterpunching would be just what the doctor ordered.
That's a better prescription for him. Oh, what a hook upstairs.
Keep moving.
Doubles up the jab. See how he targets that hook? Coming to the halfway point of this third round.
Jump on him. Nice.
Takes one but gives one. Good work by Evander Holyfield. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. Fires right back at him. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it.
Uppercut.
10 clicks of the talk. How about that left hand? And this round comes to an end.
That's it. Just like that.
The quick takeaway from the first three rounds is that one guy's got the higher punch output, the other one's lagging behind. As we start round number four, Teddy's scorecard, three rounds to none.
Yeah, the one guy with the high punch rate, the reason he's winning, and the reason why he's effective is he's in the geography of the ring he needs to be, in tight.
Looking good.
Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. And now targeting his opponent with the overhand right.
Let's see some more head movement.
Very nice work from both men. They each got a shot in.
Keep it going.
Oh, that's good stuff. Firing right back with one of his own. Good work by Evander Holyfield. Halfway through round number four. They both decide to bring it. Evander Holyfield's doing exactly what you should to be a strong defensive fighter. You got to block those punches away. Oh, he took some damage, but he gave some back with the right hand.
Mike Tyson's been able to avoid having any of his opponent's headshots landing flush.
And what his opponent has to do, Joe, is make an adjustment. What we used to tell the fighters, when a guy's elusive, like this fighter is right now, you have to shorten your punches up. Shorten them up a little bit, have less space to travel. They have a better chance of getting to that elusive target.
Good uppercut by Evander Holyfield. Comes right back with a shot of his own. Unable to make an impact there by Evander Holyfield. 10 seconds to go in the fourth.
Listen, I'm not going to stand here and watch you take those shots. You understand?
And that round is underway, and we are halfway through the scheduled slate. See, that's the work they want to see with the right hand by Mike Tyson. Evander Holyfield's jammed by an uppercut.
You got this one.
Well-targeted hook by Evander Holyfield. Mike Tyson with a big uppercut. Good fast jab from Holyfield. Evander Holyfield's on the bat. Oh, he is stunned. He could go down. Boy, he was hurt, but now he's gathered himself a bit. Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. Still plenty of time to work here in round number five. A minute and a half to go. There's the combo downstairs. Takes a step back, then the counter punch by Evander Holyfield.
Very similar to what you see Floyd Mayweather do. You know, make a miss, pull that shoulder back, and then come right back with the counter.
Not able to land the headshot.
You're still not moving enough. Move.
Holyfield with a block. Evander Holyfield's right in the way of that hook to the head. Oh, that had a hurt.
It's okay. Pay him back.
A well-placed left hand up top. And that's the end of round five. Tyson's in dominating form here tonight. He's doing everything he wanted to do, and he's ahead on our scorecards ringside.
Yeah, but don't forget, he's in the other guy's hometown. So don't let up too soon. Don't start partying too soon. You know, still keep doing the things you were doing to get you to this place.
Another round. Will it go in another one-way direction? It's been a one-sided fight so far tonight. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark.
You're not focused. Come on, get focused.
Go hit him.
Oh, and they decide to trade there. And yet another right hand lands. Iron Mike with a big uppercut. Back and forth exchange. Evander Holyfield's right hand scores well that time. He took a go of it to the body but came up empty. Holyfield's doing exactly what he told us he would do. Now, he was stunned earlier in this fight, but he's sticking to that game plan.
You know, I like that. You know, I want to see how a guy behaves under pressure. He hasn't panicked, you know. He still believes in his identity, believes in his talents, his abilities, and he's going to stay that way unless the guy convinces him later on.
Hey, keep your hands up.
Mike Tyson with a big right hand. Oh, that uppercut got him badly.
Look at that! You know, when you bully the bully, you can do that right there. Tyson floored by the power. Tyson's getting back up to his feet after being knocked down.
You need to keep that.
Working our way towards the bell, last 10 seconds of the sixth. A stinging uppercut by Evander Holyfield. Evander Holyfield's got to understand that he is down on these scorecards. He has to go out there and turn things around in the late goings. Tyson's corner did a good job during those 60 seconds between rounds. You can tell that he's a fresh fighter, not the fighter that was clearly dazed in the last round. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left-hand scores. Tyson swinging and missing like he's at bat right there. That punch was nowhere near his opponent. And now just wasting everybody's time holding on.
Keep pushing.
Nice block by Mike Tyson. Halfway through the seventh round. Not the most accurate uppercut you'll see. Holyfield connects with a huge right hand. Targeting upstairs. Tyson's doing damage on the inside with the uppercut here.
Yeah, but he's got to be careful he don't go to the well once too often, because, and he's got to be careful that he stays true to his technique, because if he drops that hand for the uppercut just a little bit, there's going to be an opening for his opponent to counter him.
Hate yourself.
Not an accurate. Mike Tyson's banged by a right hand. Big, big shot comes crashing home. He got to Iron Mike. Now Iron Mike needs to get to himself, find a way to dig deep and climb up off the canvas.
Hurry up,
one, two, three, four,
come on,
five.
Get to your feet.
And round seven comes to an end.
This one, last round, and it's yours, okay? You keep your distance. Hands up.
Bless is just a good, solid fight. Yes, he's leading on your scorecard here as we begin round number eight, but there has been some back and forth, some give and take.
His opponent has found some kinks in the armor, namely that right hand over the jab.
Good return fire that time. Tyson's trying to get back to where he was here in this round. He was knocked down in the last round. Now, Teddy, when you're the opponent and you knock the guy down, those opening few moments of the next round, do you try to size up and kind of take into account where your opponent is? Do you look into his eyes and assess the situation?
Well, I don't know if you get close enough to look right into his eyes as the opponent, but first of all, in the corner, you better not send your fighter out if his eyes don't look clear. That's your responsibility, looking out for the fighter. But as the opponent out there, you look at his legs. If his legs look a little wobbly, you get right on him.
And he returns on that exchange. That was a miss by Mike Tyson. Just a minute to go in this bout. The
Well, that was his intention, and that's what he's doing. Not engaging in the fight, but clinching. Comes right back at him with a left hand. Targeting each other, the exchange was something special. By sending more than one at him now, the combo to the head. Who would have ever thought it with two guys like this, brawlers, ladies, punchers, that they would go to a decision? Evander Holyfield's reacting as if he should have won. Teddy, I know you feel he's lucky just to have a draw.
Yeah, Christmas came early as far as I'm concerned.
Good, enjoyable, entertaining fight it was. For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore saying thanks for being with us.
Yeah, you shook my hand, but that was back then. We're not good, fam. I'm the fool because I started to be cruel, but I got schooled in the